mercy, please God erase us. I can take another complication. Have mercy, please God erase us. What is up, guys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to our final episode of the Road to World Cup, and it's the World Cup final between Hungary and Slovenia in the Soccer City Stadium, and wonderful World Cup trophy. Look at these guys. This is what we are playing for. This is the trophy that we were fighting for all the qualifiers, all the friendly matches, all the group stage games in the World Cup and the knockout stages. It's a small miracle that Hungary have made to this World Cup. We have been very lucky in the quarterfinal against Argentina with the 90th minute own goal, and we missed two penalties in the semi-final against Turkey, but we still managed to go through. And now this is the game of our lives. Hungary played two World Cups in the history of football, in 1938 and 1954, and they lost them both. So this is the hopefully third time lucky for our Hungarian national team. And here you can see the lineups, and the Slovenian team is also a small miracle that they made it to the World Cup final. We were in the same group in the qualifiers, and we have drawn 1-1 at home, and I have beaten Slovenia 2-1 away, if I remember correctly. I will show you all the highlights from this game. Some of you may have commented that I should do a live commentary, but that would have been too long a video to show the whole game, but maybe next time I will do it online on the Ultimate Team or something. And here the referee gives a red card, and the Hungarian fans can't believe it. They are absolutely livid. And here in the 24th minute, guess what happens? The referee gives another penalty. What is it with this World Cup and the penalties? We get so many penalties for slight tackles, it's unbelievable. And the Slovenian player just slight tackled my striker, who wanted to shoot. And here Husti missed two penalties in the semi-finals, so I select Zuzsák. Hopefully he doesn't miss one, and Zuzsák steps up and scores, and yes! Hungary is in front in the World Cup final, and Zuzsák is blowing kisses to the crowd, and the Hungarian fans are absolutely mental in the stands, and I am jumping the air in delight. And this is a wonderful, wonderful penalty. Look at the Hungarian fans. Nice haircut, dude, well done. we are 1-0 up, and I wanted to talk about the 1954 World Cup, which was very interesting. We had the most amazing team in the world back then. Most of you don't know about that team because you were too young to see that team play, but that team had some legendary players in them, and they were unbeaten for 3 years in world football, and they have beaten England and Wembley 6-3, and the English wanted a revenge game, and they got their revenge game. The replay was played in Hungary, and after the 6-3 loss by England, Hungary played England at home, and they have won 7-1, and that was the first time England have lost at Wembley ever. And that game, that team had some legendary players: Puskás, Hidakuti, Cibor, Kocsis, and half time passed, so we are in the second half. So that team was unbeaten for 3 years, and they have gone to the World Cup with to be favorites, and they have clashed with the Germans in the group stages, and they have won 8-3. Yes, 8-3. They have beaten the Germans by 5 goals in the group stages. But the Germans applied a very dirty tactic, because our best player Zuzsák was injured deliberately by the Germans. And we meet the Germans in the final as well. Hungary got 2-0 up inside the first 8 minutes. And then the referee disallowed an absolutely legitimate German, sorry, Hungarian goal, and then he allowed an offside goal by Germany. So Germany came back to win 3-2, and that was their first ever World Cup win. And that game is called the Miracle of Bern, if I remember correctly. It was played in Switzerland, if I'm not mistaken. So that in that year we should have won the World Cup, because it's amazing to say, but we had the best team in the world back then. We have beaten England comfortably, and we have beaten all the other teams in the World Cup except the Germans. And after so many years, just lately it was discovered that the Germans used illegal substances. They were doping, but back then there wasn't any doping rules, so they can't be punished, and we can't get back our World Cup win, which is a real shame. But I hopefully can make up in this game for that. And we are already 2-0 up, and Giugia gets the ball and he smashes in the third goal. And this is it, guys. 3-0 up in the World Cup final. We surely can't lose from this position. This is the 80th minute, and this is the wonderful goal by Žužak, and he is the one of the best players in the tournament for sure. He has another chance here, but the keeper saves this time. And it's only 2 minutes left from the World Cup final, and we keep on attacking. And Hamosi, my substitute, gets a great chance, and the goalkeeper saves. And it's only minutes till the final whistle is blown by the referee, and all the Hungarian fans and players are eagerly awaiting the final whistle. But here we still manage to get the shot away, and yes, Hungary is World Cup champions. We are the champions of the world. Wonderful achievement by this small country and small team. It's only a 3.5-star team, and I never in my life, I never imagined that I could win this World Cup with this team. My main goal was to qualify for the World Cup finals, and the Hungarian fans are absolutely ecstatic, absolutely jumping the air in the light. Look at this stadium, look at the celebrations, look at all the players jumping for joy. This is the best ever presentations that can be seen in a football game. I absolutely love it. All the players worked so hard for this win. They played out of their skin in the qualifiers, and let's see the fans jumping and celebrating. Let's see the trophy presentation now. This is absolutely wonderful. I'm just absolutely thrilled, and I just lost for words. Guerra is the team captain, and all the players are kissing the World Cup trophy. It's the most important and most prestigious trophy in the world of football that anyone can win, and all the players are can't wait to get their hands on the World Cup trophy. And here it is. Yes! Hungary are World Cup champions. We are the champions of the world. The best team, as the commentator said. And the confetti is thrown in the air. And I just let you take in the atmosphere here. Look at this. Oh, absolutely amazing, guys. Thanks for all your support in this series. Thanks for all the comments, the likes, the views. I truly appreciate each and every single one of you taking a look at my videos, and I hope you enjoyed this series. I'm a bit sad that this series is coming to an end, because it was a great series. I truly enjoyed playing with Hungary, and I have never imagined that I would get so much joy with playing them and so much success. And this is just unbelievable scenes. Hungary winning the World Cup trophy, that surely would never happen in real life. Sadly, our best glory days are over. I would be more than happy if we ever qualified for a major tournament in the next 6 or 8 years for a European Championship or the World Cup. And here you can see that Turkey have won the bronze game 2-1 against Iran. And here are the all the results and all the statistics. And Bujaki got 2 goals in the World Cup. You has got 3 goals, sorry, you has got 2. And here are all the assists. And these are the top scorers of the 2010 FIFA World Cup Finals in South Africa. And this is the qualifier statistics where the top two top scorers were Hungarian strikers, Zuzsák and Gera. And here are the World Cup, the world rankings, and Hungary is on 37th place. So that shows how big an achievement this was, beating all the other teams en route to the World Cup trophy. Here are the Golden Ball winners. Zuzsák got first place, and thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this episode and this series. This is the end of the series, but I will have a new series coming up shortly. Please like the video if you enjoyed. See you later. Bye.